So Bob, Mayweather Marquez did a million buys. This seems to, on paper, to be a more attractive fight. What kind of numbers do you think you'll do?
Well, we think we're going to do considerably more than they did in that fight. We're very encouraged with the number that they reached because it just shows that the popularity of boxing is there and it's back. And everybody's talking about this fight, Mayweather's return, and the help of the sport. So it's all good.
Are you looking to match up the winner of this fight with Mayweather, or you think that's not doable? It's pretty much going to be at the top of the boxing world. How far much of a hit will the loser take?
I don't think the loser's going to take any hit. I really believe that this fight will be so good and so exciting that there won't be a loser. Now, one guy's hand will be raised to victory, but the loser won't be a loser. His stature in boxing.
Are you going to do theaters like the Mayweather Marquez?
No, we don't plan to. We have a lot of other marketing tools that we're going to be doing. And we have no plans to show this fight again.
What's the status of Edwin Valero, and is he a possible opponent for these guys down the line?
I would have liked to say yes. Valero is a very exciting fighter, but he has difficulties. When he came for the Pacquiao fight, after the fight, he got himself drunk and drove a car, and they picked him up, and they cited him for the DUI. On the basis of that DUI, he left the country. Because he has to go to rehab. And he complicated his ultimately applying for a visa by attacking the U.S. government and said that they denied him the visa because he's a friend of Hugo Chavez, which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
So hopefully when it all gets sorted out, we will get him a visa. But that is too late to consider it.
Do you think it's going to be any problem to get Margarito relicensed?
I don't think so. Not after he spends his 1 year under the rules of the ABC, the Association of Boxing Commission. After the year, he can apply for a license in any state. He doesn't have to go back to California.
So you're looking to bring him back in February right away, or you got to... Just a couple of weeks after this fight, then you've got the huge Kelly Pavlik fight with Paul Williams. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I'm
still going to get a big contingent of people coming from Youngstown for that fight? Already? Wow. Then this fight's long sold. Then you've got another one on December 19th. You've got a Latin Fury, right?
Yeah, we have Latin Fury.
Who's headlining that?
Hopefully, and that's going to be in Cancun. And hopefully it'll headline Julio Chavez Jr. But of course, he's in a tough fight.
That sounds like you're working on setting up Chavez Jr. against Duddy down the line.
Absolutely. We hope to do that in Madison Square Garden in the spring of 2010.
Terrific. And is that pretty much all you've got lined up, or you got any other great things in store for us? That'd be interesting, yeah. Okay, all right, great. Thanks, Bob.